opens an interesting discussion. He says, وَالَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ. He is the one who's revealed the book to you. مِنْهُ آيَاتٌ مُحْكَمَاتٌ. In it contained clear verses, decisive verses. هُنَّ أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ. Which are the basis of the book, the majority of the book. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions آيَاتٌ مُحْكَمَاتٌ, clear, unambiguous verses. What does that mean? And ulama Quran has a lot of discussion what it means. Essentially saying that there's no unclarity within these verses. Like when it says not to lie, not to backbite, when it says to pray, to fast, to give zakat and so on, these are clear, at one level they're clear what's meant by them. There's no scope for any ambiguity within these. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Hunna Ummul Kitab. These are the Ummul Kitab and Rasul Kitab. This is the basis of the revelation itself. When you look at the Quran and Sunnah, the vast majority is clear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Quran in Arabic and Mubin. That we've revealed it in the Quran, in an Arabic Quran, which is clear. But then it talks about other verses. وَأُخَرُ مُتَشَابِهَاتِ. And this is where our difficulty is. مُتَشَابِهَاتِ. مُتَشَابِهَاتِ are verses where there's ambiguity, or there's some degree of unclarity within those verses. مُتَشَابِهَاتِ. Ambiguous verses. The most obvious example of that are what we call al-huruf al-muqatta'ah, the broken letters in the Quran. Which are what? Alif lam mim, Taha, Yasin, Qaf, Noon, Kafa, Ya'in, Sad. Broken letters. These are just letters that have come together in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has wisdoms behind why he's put them. What do these letters, what does alif lam mean? What does Taha mean? What does Yasin mean? Mufassirin amongst the Sahaba, they suggested, amongst Sahaba and those who came after, they suggested explanations for these. But what do, as a whole, the Mufassirin said, Allahu a'lamu bil murad. Allah subhanahu alone knows what these mean. What's that telling you? We can never truly know what these letters mean in the Quran. What's suggested are merely suggestions. There's nothing definitive in the answers in what's given there. What's important though about these, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about mutashabihat in the Quran, فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ زَيْغٌ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ ابْتِغَاءَ الْفِتْنَةِ وَابْتِغَاءَ التَّأْوِيلِ. Those who have a deviance in their hearts, زَيْغ, those who have, and if their hearts swerve away from the true path, they seek out these verses. And what's the point of ambiguous verses, the broken letters? Pass by them. Don't reflect over it, just pass by them, read them, pass by them, believe in them, read them, pass by them. And that's why, interestingly, you have the beginning of Quran after Fatiha, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. When you pray for guidance in the Quran, you said, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, guide us on the straight path. The answer comes, هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, that this Quran is guidance. But how did it start? With words that you can never understand what they mean. Alif Lam Mim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins by testing your faith at the very beginning. He begins with words that you can never understand what they mean. What does that mean? There has to be an element of blind faith in your... There has to be an element of blind faith. Like we're always talking Islam is natural religion, everything about it makes sense. That's all good and well. But you're not necessarily going to understand everything of Islam. There are going to be aspects of Islam that you can never understand. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intentionally placed those in the Quran. Aspects that you can never understand. The bulk of it you can't. The overwhelming majority of this religion you can understand, but the Quran begins three letters, you're not going to know what it means. But then it says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابِ, this is the book, لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. After throwing you in total doubt, by starting off with أَلِفْ لَا مِين, it says there's no doubt in this. This is a book in which there's no doubt. It's a guidance of believers. And then it's the first description of believers is what? يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. They believe in the unseen. What's the Quran beginning with? A test of your faith. What are you going to rely upon? Your intellect? Are you going to rely upon absolute submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As one of our shuyukh, he said, if everything in Islam made clear sense to our intellect, our submission is not to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our submission is to our intellect. Our submission is not to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our submission is to our intellect. And that's why you have part of revelation, you cannot understand what it means. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about these parts of Revelation? فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبٍ زَيْغٌ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ مِنْ Those who have the demons in their heart, they seek out these verses. What do believers do? They don't seek them out. They accept them, they're there, we believe in them. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended by them, we believe in them. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended by them, we believe in them. اِبْتِغَاءَ الْفِتْنَةِ وَابْتِغَاءَ تَأْوِيلِ Those who have these demons, they seek out these verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اِبْتِغَاءَ الْفِتْنَةِ To seek out fitna, to seek out trouble. وَابْتِغَاءَ تَأْوِيلِ Try and understand these things. Then what's he say? وَمَا يَعْلَمُ تَأْوِيلَهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ And only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what these are. Now here, the believers, it says, وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ يَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِهِ كُلُّ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا Those who are grounded in knowledge, those who are firm in knowledge, those who are embedded in knowledge, الرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ What do they say? آمَنَّا بِهِ Anything that comes in the Quran, ambiguous or clear, we believe in it. Whether we understand it or not, we believe in it. كُلُّ مِنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا It's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why do we have ambiguous verses in the Quran? To test your faith. To test your faith. To see, when you know that this has come from your Lord, every single last word has come from your Lord, but you can't understand it, are you still going to believe in your Lord or not? Or are you going to start wavering? Are you going to start trying to delve into it? Are you going to start trying to understand it? When you know you can't understand it, all you can get is just an insight into it and suggestions about it. That's the nature of ambiguous verses. Broken letters included in them. I'm going to go now to certain descriptions mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah of that nature. We're going to stop for 5 minutes, right? Alhamdulillah.